Sky Sports coverage of the Tennent Scottish Cup in association with Bet365.
Since 1874, both Celtic and Rangers have made sure the Old Firm have kept this silver in the city. But not this year. The Cup's on the move, and its magic has moved the movers and shakers of Scottish football, as well as causing a few more upsets on the way.
Clyde have done it! It's a Scottish Cup shocker! Sensational stuff!
That's opened Glasgow's door for Edinburgh's finest to descend on Hampden in their thousands. An almighty clash in prospect as Hibernian face Hearts for a place in the final against 2nd Division Gretna.
Jankowskis! Chris Killen! What a fine strike that is!
It's been 104 years Hibs have had to wait since their last success, but how sweet it would be to get to the final, especially at the expense of rivals Hearts, who've created most of the headlines in Scottish football in what has been a turbulent season at Tynecastle. Could they create another by returning to Hampden for the final? It's an Edinburgh derby in Glasgow, in a sold-out Hampden Park, for a place in the Scottish Cup final. Good afternoon from Hampden Park in Glasgow, and what a game we have for you live on Sky Sports in prospect right here. If Hibs win, they'll be a step closer to ending that long-time cup jinx. If Hearts win, incredibly, that all but guarantees little Gretna, a place in the UEFA Cup. Can you believe that? Charlie Nicholas is with me here at Hampden Park this afternoon, and so too the former Hearts manager, Graham Ricks, who took them, after all, to today's semi-final. Graham, you're more than welcome. How disappointed are you, first of all, not to be leading the team out today?
It's a family show. I can't really say too much to him. Obviously, driving here, and now I'm here, the atmosphere, the fans, and I've got a great reception from the Hearts fans. And, disappointed is a good way of putting it.
Does it still hurt?
Well, it does. I'm really enjoying my time there. I thought we were doing well, and we're on the verge of having a great season. So, yeah, a little bit disappointed, but I'm sure the boys will perform today.
Are you going down to the dressing room? I believe you've been invited today.
Yeah, but it's their day. I saw the lads as they got off the coach and wished them all good luck, the coaching staff and the players. So I've done my bit. You know, it's down to them now. It's their day.
I know Graham's a chum, but he did a good job, Charlie, didn't he?
Very good job. It was a difficult situation. George Burley had done fantastically well also. But in saying that, you know, all the other stuff that came with Graham was, I think, a very unfair situation for him to get into, but he handled it. He took it in the chin. And I think what you've seen is that, you know, a lot of people always say about Ricks, he's a very good coach. But there's more than coaching involved when you get these players in. Now, you know, I mean, we sometimes make a joke of it. Sometimes he wasn't really focused on picking the whole team himself. These burdens are sent to test you. And I think you've seen by the end of his day, the Hearts' response from the players was very positive about him.
Graham, the Hearts team, we know it today. Is it the team you'd have chosen?
Well, I think there is one surprise. Obviously, Brelli is suspended, so there's no way he can play, and Benn is suspended. But, you know, Jose Gonçalves coming in at left-back for Takis Fisas. That surprised me a little bit because Takis is a very experienced player, and the back four, well, with Craig Gordon, the back five is the best in the SPL, and you know, it's a bit of a risk to change that.
If it's not broken, you don't have to fix it.
Absolutely right. I mean, the other one, Aguirre, has got no option. I suppose he's a straight swap for Brelia. But Gonçalves is a good player, but it's a big, big risk, I think, playing him.
Do you think the manager's chosen that team, Graham, or Mr. Romanov?
good try, Jim. I only sleep at night, mate.
Is it a strong team? Is it a team that will win today?
I think it's a strong team. I think they've got power up front. I think they've got a great back four, as I said. And I think in Paul Hartley midfield, they've got a dynamo who's a likely match winner.
OK, Graham, Charlie, more from you in a moment. But one interested spectator here at Hampden today is that man, Rowan Alexander, the Gretna manager. They're in the final, but who will he face in that final? Will it be Hearts or Hibs? Let's just see how those two teams got to the last four. Hibs began with a home tie against third divisioner Broth. It proved to be a rather one-sided affair as Tony Mowbray's men hit six to claim their place in the next round. Hearts faced a sterner test when they came up against the man who led them to cup victory in 98. But for Jim Jeffries, it was not to be a happy return. After beating Rangers twice in the league already, Hibs headed to Ibrox in confident mood.
Twisting and turning, and Gary O'Connor is there, and Hibs take the lead at Ibrox. Oh, here's to Ivan Sproul. Ryden's touch, slipping it through here for Killen, and he's going to get another chance. He's put it away, Chris Killen.
Meanwhile at Tynecastle, three first-half goals were enough to see off Aberdeen. Hibs' high scoring continued in the quarter-final. With a little help from Falkirk, Derek Reardon's free kick set them on the way as Hibs hit five. After putting out Cali Thistle, second division Partick Thistle's hopes of creating another shot didn't last long at Tynecastle.
Lovely. Makes it into the cross, it's a good one, Yekaskis! Yekaskis determined to get his shot away! Sensational strike! Just ensure a place in the semi-finals for Hearts.
That's how they got here today then. This will be the 270th meeting between these two. It's the first ever outside Edinburgh. In the Cup, well, it's a close thing. Hearts have a slight advantage. And Hearts won it back in 1998. That was at Celtic Park. They beat Rangers. But for Hibs, it's been a much, much longer wait.
Tony, how big is today's game to Hibernian?
Yeah, it's a huge game everywhere. You know, everywhere you go, really, Hibs supporters are stopping you in the street, and I think there's a nervous tension about the supporters. It's you know, we've got to make sure that doesn't transmit to the players. They'll obviously be nervous, but once the game starts, we've got 11 players out there in green shirts that are going to try and do it for the club, for the fans. It's been a long, long time. Scottish Cup, everybody keeps telling us. It was 103 last year, it's 104 this year. Let's hope it doesn't get 105.
Home advantage has been crucial in all of this season's Edinburgh derbies. How do you expect the game to go on neutral territory?
Well, it's a good game for us. Tynecastle is a very, very difficult place to go and play. It's a very tight, very fast surface, and the crowd are right on top of you. It's very intimidating. They play very, very quick. At Easter Road, the game was a little bit more open and more relaxed, more of an atmosphere and an environment like there is out here today, and hopefully that will suit us.
Disappointing team news. No Chris Killen, no Michael Stewart. Scott Brown hasn't made it either. How big a collective blow is that?
Well, obviously you want to come into big football matches with your best players available, and so it has been a disappointment for us. But the lads who come in, they will give everything they've got. As I say, you have a squad for that reason. Really, everybody's required. You've got to trust them all, and we're very confident in the team that we'll put out there today.
Tony, good luck.
Cheers. Thanks a lot.
Tony Mowbray. So Benjelin, the Moroccan, comes in today. It's a cup semi-final. He makes his debut. And Graham, he was granted a work permit this week after agreeing to sign for Hibs 2 months ago. So this is tough for Tony Mowbray today, isn't it?
Just listening to Tony there, he seemed a little bit worried about the people he is missing today, and that's understandable. For this guy, it's a great opportunity. He's a bit of an unknown quantity, and I'm sure Stevie Presley and Andy Webster won't mind either kick.
Brixie knows how Hibs play. You know, they like to pass and move, and this pitch, I think, will help him because there'll be a lot more space. We obviously haven't seen this lad. Killen's more of a target man. He's not as mobile as, say, O'Connor was. But the little Moroccan, if he's going to be quick and busy up the side of Presley, up the side of Webster, they might get a bit of joy out of that. But they've got to get quick support from midfield.
Big blow too, obviously, Graham, they're missing Killen, they're missing Stewart. These are key players, and this is a key game.
And O'Connor's gone, obviously, and Reid.
He's gone to Moscow,
so,
yeah.
You know, I mean, it's difficult for Tony, but I was just saying to Charlie earlier, big pitch, I think it'll suit Hibs, you know, and I think Sproul could be a real threat because of the open spaces here.
We saw what they did at Ibrox.
Certainly did.
Charlie, they destroyed Rangers.
Yeah.
They are very, very quick on the break, as Graham rightly says.
Yeah, and they're quite good at passing it. I know Riordan is a big miss for them, but they are good at passing, and they left him on the bench at Ibrox that day. But I think they're missing the mobility of O'Connor. But in saying that, we'll see how the Moroccan feels. But I'd be tempted if I was Hibs to play Sproul, start him, or give him a time on the left-hand side. Because I think inside Nielsen and Presley, I think there's a weakness there that pace can get at you. And I think if you start giving them that problem, you start to think a little bit more about it.
All right, chaps, more from you at half-time. Let's get to kick-off now. It's Hibs against Hearts. It's a Scottish Cup semi-final in a sold-out Hampden Park this Sunday afternoon in Glasgow. Let's get to it and join David Provenant first. As always, Ian Crocker.
Thank you, Jim. Not much good news for Hibs. Top scorer Derek Riordan suspended, and injured trio Michael Stewart, Chris Killen and Scott Brown have all failed to make it, while Paul Dalglish is cup side. So there's a debut in a semi-final for the young Moroccan striker Abdeslam Benjelloun, who only received his work permit this week. Ivan Sproul has scored in every round, but he and Gary Caldwell are a booking away from missing the final or a replay. For Hearts, Robbie Nielsen and Stephen Presley have shaken off knocks. Andy Webster has recovered from illness. Gonsalves is preferred to Fisas. Paul Hartley used to play for Hibs and has scored three times against them this season. Rudy Scansell is the top scorer, though he's been a bit off form lately. Striker Callum Elliott turned 19 on Thursday. He's had quite a season. Julian Brellier and Roman Bednar are suspended.
Well, Hibs badly hit with injury today, and as you said previously, but there's still plenty of mobility and plenty of energy about that side. We've set them up 4-3-3 here, but I think when Hibs don't have possession of the ball, that will become 4-5-1. Stephen Fletcher in particular will be expected to shut off Hearts' supply to Chesnauskas on that side of the pitch. Gary Caldwell comes out of the back four today to sit in the centre area of a tight midfield three, and they're going to have to make sure that Paul Hartley isn't getting in between their midfield and their back line. Further forward, as Charlie said, no shortage of pace with Sproul supporting Benjelloun from the wide area. Usual 4-4-2 for Hearts today. Maybe a slight surprise, as Graham said, that Gonsalves kicks an on over Fisas at left back. That may be with the pace of Sproul in mind down that side of the pitch. On the far side of the pitch, Chesnauskas. Love this fella, and he'll certainly do his best to get a David Murphy, get in behind. And if he is, Scatchell will come in from the left-hand side to become a third striker beside Jankauskas and Elliott. Aguiar certainly has a hard act to follow, coming in for the suspended Brellier today, and he's going to have to sit with the game in front of him and allow Paul Hartley to do what he does best, getting into the box.
Glasgow has become the Scottish capital for the day. Hibs, Hearts, Hampden, it's the Edinburgh Derby on tour. In the footballing city of Glasgow, old foes, arch enemies, fierce rivals, yes, it's Hibs and Hearts. Edinburgh's old firm have come to town. A semi-final to savour is coming up.
The Tennent Scottish Cup in association with Bet3.
It's an Edinburgh derby in Glasgow this Sunday afternoon for a place in the Scottish Cup final. It's Hibs against Hearts. Let's get to it. The atmosphere, absolutely electric. David Provan and Ian Crocker.
It's the Edinburgh Festival of Football. For the winners, the chance to pip your rivals to a place in the Scottish Cup final. For the losers, oh no, oh dear, let's not even think of it. They say nobody remembers losing semi-finalists, but whoever loses today will be remembered, because the other half of Edinburgh won't let them forget it. Gonsalves preferred to Fisas at left back for Hearts. Colin Elliott lurking. It's intercepted by Chesnauskas, and now Gonsalves. Hearts proving to be an early threat. If Scotcher can get it across, and it's a goal kick.
A great early work from Hartzell. Gonsalves right up the touchline. Gary Caldwell sold himself in here. Scatzell made a good angle, and Hibs do well to crowd that front post area. Early warning for Hibs though. Great run from Scatzell.
Well, Valdes Ivanauskas is the latest man to take charge of Hearts. And he's up against Tony Mowbray. He's had a rather more settled season across the city of Edinburgh, although it is Hearts who occupy second place in the league. And the flag is up against Jankauskas. Usually on semi-final weekend, the old firm are hogging Hampden, but not so this time. Celtic and Rangers long gone from this competition. In a season of shocks, it's Edinburgh's turn to be up for the cup. Little Gretna awaiting the winners in the final. Perhaps not so little anymore. A free kick for Hibs. Hibs missing some key players today, but can they strike early? Kevin Thompson is the man to deliver the free kick. And Gonsalves going to throw off Whittaker.
A good defensive header from Hartley as the ball came in there from Thompson. Good foot free kick, and it was Hartley who was first to get his head to it. Gary Caldwell flat's going to play right back. They move Whittaker in beside Thompson and Glass in the central area.
For Hearts, and a chance to show what they can do, conceded by Chris Hogg.
Well, I think we're going to see a lot of this. The semi-finals are never really enjoyable. There's so much tension about and so much caution.
Hearts not hanging around, but Skintzel making the most of the cross. Markle and Strachan's Celtic could clinch the Scottish title against Hearts on Wednesday night. Nielsen. And another free kick. Hogg's foul on Jankauskas. Gonsalves ran in to Thompson.
Jankauskas wanted it early. Gonsalves got the ball. Jankauskas got himself inside right channel towards the back post. And that's the variation that the Hearts have. You can get the centre forward into the game early. Has a good physical presence about him if they want to miss out the midfield and go long.
Caldwell's throw. Tony Mowbray was certainly cagey about how he was going to play it today with so many players out. Hartley slipping it through here. And a first strike from Jankauskas. It's well held by Markowski.
I don't think he really had a chance here. I don't think he's scoring from this angle. But there's no support. And you can see there's no support. He's got to take the shot on.
Thompson and Hartley both go for it. Sproul. It's only the second time Hibs and Hearts have met at the semi-final stage of the Scottish Cup. The only other time was merely 105 years ago in 1901, and for the record, Hearts won that day and went on to lift the famous trophy. Jankauskas losing out to Hogg. And it was driven by Fletcher.
making something pretty score from that range. Must be the best part of 35 yards out. Sproul Lou on the green and white jersey ahead of him, so not many, too many options. Sproul already drifting into that central area. And if Hearts do close the game up and offer Hibs space in behind, he certainly has the pace to hurt them.
Stephen Presley up against Ivan Sproul. Corner.
I'm surprised you should have let it go. I thought he was going to give a free kick. Free kick for me.
There's a corner for the Hibs. It's the Hearts fans who are occupying that half of Hampden. Thompson takes it. Benjaloon had a go, and so did Caldwell. Jankauskas helped out there by his fellow Lithuanian Kuznauskas. Gonsalves is making great strides to get to this. He was just unlucky there, but boy did he run.
Well, I deserved a far better volley. It's not an easy pick out. Gonsalves is totally unmarked on the left-hand side. Kuznauskas into Jankauskas. There was nobody in the right-back position for Hibs. With a better weight of ball, Gonsalves is into a good area there on that side.
Gonsalves did his Forrest Gump impression, but couldn't quite get there in time. Presley's header. It's gone over Presley's head and skipped away from Sproul too. Andy Webster covering. Flick on from Jankauskas. Knocked up by Caldwell. Vasquez unable to return it to great effect. Finally frustrated as it dribbled over the line. Thompson put under unfair pressure by Elliott. A young striker who's had quite a season, turned 19 on Thursday. Caldwell then will take this. Away by Presley. Knocked on by Skatzel. Back up for Hibs. And they're not hanging around. Caldwell. Oops. Gonna go for the corner.
It's a good early free kick from Stephen Glass. As soon as it was given, knocked it out wide to Gary Caldwell. Just trying to make a better angle to get something into the box.
Caldwell and the Hog have joined the throng. Thompson's corner, and Robbie Nielsen had to head it away. And it's come back to Greg Gordon. Hibs and Hearts feeling their way into this Scottish Cup semi-final. And it will be a fairy tale final after Gretna overcame Dundee here yesterday. But they did enough to suggest that they will give either Hibs or Hearts a game back here in May. Gonsalves, who has a really long throw on him, and Jankauskas trying the overhead kick. There's a fair few free kicks in the opening 10 minutes.
Previous to that, good link-up play from Hearts front two. It's Callum Elliott who wins this at the front post, just helps it into the box. It's behind Jankauskas, awkward tight. And that's just about all he could attempt here, the overhead kick.
Caldwell. This is Murphy. Robbie Nielsen, who I'm sure is trying to look more and more like Stephen Presley as every day goes by. Smith in towards Ben Jaloon, making his debut. Stuart Dougal not interested in his fall, but Sproul has set up Caldwell, who hasn't delivered.
I've got to do better. He's under no pressure, Gary Caldwell. He's got loads of time. Gonsalves is never getting out to him. And there's good support in the box if he whips something in. Did the right thing trying to get it in early, but he's got to do better than that.
Tony Mowbray won the Scottish Cup as a player for Celtic in 1995. And he now win it as a manager. Jankauskas. Sproul on the chase. But Stephen Presley having none of it. David Murphy, released by Middlesbrough a couple of years ago, will take this throw. There's no return forthcoming from Stephen Glass. Nielsen with the long throw. Hartley. Giant Polish keeper Malkowski making his debut in the Scottish Cup. Back into the side when Simon Brown was sent off last month against Celtic. Sproul now leaving it, and Whittaker having an excellent effort which brought the best out of Craig Gordon.
Well, he's got to be right to take the shot on. Ivan Sproul's looking for a pass on the right-hand side here. Sproul does well to win the ball here from Andy Webster. Continues his run, wants it back, but it opened up beautifully for Whittaker. It's a save you would expect Craig Gordon to make. Never really under any pressure here. Quite happy to get it behind.
Hibs posing problems again for their Edinburgh rivals. Thompson whipping it in, and what a big chance that was for Fletcher.
Oh, a bit more conviction from Hartson and your brother here. It's a good whip ball in. He's got across the front of Webster. If he throws his head at that, it's every chance he's scoring.
Fletcher for Ben Jaloon. Closely marshalled by Presley, but it's a free kick for the Moroccan debutant. He has been at Hibs for a while, but his work permit only came through this week on Tuesday. And with a few absentees, he finds himself in the starting lineup. What a game in which to make your debut. Gary Smith takes. Goal kick. Well, the Hearts interim coach, Valdas Ivanauskas, has got the better of Hibs before. He was in charge of the Lithuanian side Vetra of Vilnius, and beat Hearts in the Intertoto Cup a couple of years ago. Webster. Chesnauskas. Aguiar won't get near that. It's hoisted clear by Murphy. Presley playing it safe. Nowhere to go really for Murphy. But back to Smith. to put a man down. And Guiar, meantime, has launched it towards Hartley, who was the furthest man forward, and Whittingham is now back on his feet. And here he is. The best of layoffs for Thompson.
And Paul Hartley, they're only just made it, and I think Hartley will be quite happy that Hibs have basically lined up 4-4-2, Sproles up front with Benjaloon, and it's 2 against 2 in that central area. Both Glass and Thompson are going to have to be wary of Hartley's running.
Hartley standing over this with Scatzel. It's a long way out. You never know with Scatzel. It is left for Scatzel. Maybe two men in the wall, but that proved to be enough. Chesnauskas. It's taken by Markowski.
I think he's happier on his right side, Chesnauskas. But he gives them great cutting edge down that side. Always trying to get in behind, go at defenders.
And nearly for Ivan Sproul. Hearts were the last club from outside the Old Firm to win the Scottish Cup when they beat Rangers in 1998. A bit of a bubble there for Markowski by the look of it. Chesnauskas. Here we are, replacing the suspended Breliat, who puts in a shift for Hearts. And Robbie Nielsen. Thompson now looking to lead a Hibs charge. Fletcher. Benjaloon. Stephen Whittaker got that wrong.
I'm just surprised he didn't pull the trigger. I know he's what, 25 yards out, but again, there's nothing really on for him. Sproul's made a run, but he's really too wide to try and pick out. He had a good first time layoff from Benjaloon. I'm just surprised that Whittaker didn't try and shift and hit there.
Well, he had a pop earlier. But it was a comfortable save for Craig Gordon. Decided against a second attempt. Gordon's going to have to come and come out that. Craig Gordon, Scotland's number one. In fact, the Hearts coach, Ivan Askus, reckons he's the best keeper in the world at his age. And certainly Graham Ricks and George Burley speak very highly of him too. Benjaloon, who can be a box of tricks, has been fouled by Aguiar.
It's a different type from Rankowskis, who's far less of a target. He wants to come short and link the game. Looks as if he's got a good touch. Good foul for Sproul, who's happier going in behind.
Another chance then for Thompson to deliver, and Gary Caldwell coming in on it.
Well, he's over Andy Webster. Andy Webster having a look over at Gonsalves here. I just wonder if he does run off Gonsalves. And he's up. Andy Webster doesn't see him coming. If anything, it's just a little bit too high there for Gary Caldwell, who might have been in the down as he makes contact. But he got away from Gonsalves.
Well, he's off to Celtic in the summer. He'll be hoping that his last game for Hibs, it's the Scottish Cup final, and of course he's the captain, so he would lift the trophy if they won it. Bit of work to be done before that particular dream is realised. Chesnauskas. Cannons off Murphy. Chesnauskas scored a cracker against Partick Thistle in the quarter-final, which proved decisive. Hearts a little fortunate to get through that tie. I'm sure Dick Campbell and his boys are watching this thinking what might have been.
have a free kick.
Well, Benjamin's got to do better. He can't afford to lose the ball midway inside his own half. It's a poor touch. Gonsalves was on his way. That's what forced the free kick. Maybe just on the edge of range here. At least 30 yards out. Paul Hartley looks as if he might fancy this.
Hartley, a former Hibs player, but he has been in the habit of scoring against them this season. Three goals in all, two of them from the penalty spot. Hartley does give it a go. Tremendous try, and Markowski scrambled to get that.
Well, if he's going to beat Markowski from that range, he's got to find one of the top corners. And to be fair to Paul Hartley, it's a very good effort. Again, I think it's a save you'd expect the goalkeeper to make. Gets his hand up. And he certainly had to move his feet quickly to get across.
Well, Hartley himself will take the corner. Presley not allowed to get near it. And Aguiar's going to volley it back in. Chesnowski's on his left foot.
That's a very good piece of technique here from Paul Hartley. Plenty of pace in the ball, just a little bit too far out. Markowski can see it when it comes up over the wall. He's got time to move his feet and get across and deal with it.
These Edinburgh rivals were losing semi-finalists last season. Hearts lost to Celtic. Hibs blew it against Dundee United. 12 months on. There will be further agony for one of them and complete ecstasy for the other. Unlike in England, there are replays in the semi-final stage of the Scottish Cup, so if it does end in a draw here, we'll all come back to Hampden a week on Wednesday. Here we are. Benjamin crashing in, and Fletcher for Ivan Sproul, but Webster in the way. Kaskis. Gary Caldwell. Good service. Dougal's whistle, getting a good blow today.
That's good defending. Gonsalves is out of position there. Gary Caldwell would have been on his way. Good defending.
Caldwell's free kick. Should end up with Craig Gordon. Webster. Nielsen. Well, it's come through to Elliott. And now Paul Hartley. He'll take it on himself. Against his former club.
Decent effort. It's Gary Smith who's caught forward here as the ball was played up to Jankowski. As Gary Smith goes forward to make the challenge, all of a sudden Hearts are in behind. I'm sure Paul Hartley would rather have been coming in from the other side there to open the goal up. Thought about taking it on his left, and on his right there's no real room there to get it out of his body.
Smith, who was sent off against Hart in one of the league meetings this season, will take the free kick. In those league meetings, Hart thumped Hibs twice at Tynecastle. Hibs, though, did get their revenge in the Easter Road encounter. Whittaker. Man on the mission. Sproul had gone offside, so he had to hold it up. Caldwell now. He's put Thompson in. There's a few waiting, including Ivan Sproul, who's got no power on it.
It's so difficult to score when you're that far outside the front post. Hibs made a terrific angle. Good ball from Gary Caldwell. Sproul was hoping he stepped over this. You see Sproul on the penalty spot. Benjulin, I should say. Sproul tried to take it on. Difficult angle.
Well, he has scored in every round of the Scottish Cup this season. Ivan Sproul. Scored that incredible early season hat-trick against Rangers. And scored against them again at Ibrox. And Hibs completed the Scottish Cup demolition job on the Old Firm this season, which Clyde had started. Smith. Benjulun. Scantle for Hartley. Now, opportunities here. And Kaskas arriving on the scene. Hartley! Paul Hartley gives Hearts the lead in this all-Edinburgh semi against his old club. And that has fired a few dreams at Hampden.
Well, there's a heavy price to be paid even when you lose the ball. And it's Benjulin, I'm afraid, who loses it here. Midway inside the Hearts half of the pitch. But watch the break and watch the support from Hartley. Jankowski says it's time to look up. Hartley continues the run. And that is the deftest of touches with the outside of his right foot. And that is a big price to pay for losing the ball midway inside your own half. It was Benjulin who gave the ball up. And only a matter of seconds later, it's in the back of the Hibs net.
Well, it had to be him. It's the fourth time he scored against Hibs this season. Scotland's most improved player over the last couple of years. Never really happened for him when he was at Hibs, but it's certainly happening for him now at Hearts, a full international, albeit late in his career. He's some player, and he's given Hearts the edge. Whittaker looking for a quick response, but not troubling Gordon with that.
The lesson here for Hibs in terms of the goal is if your midfield players have gone beyond you, you can't afford to lose the ball. But watch Hartley's run here. He plays it wide, continues his run. Slide rule ball in from Jankowskis, isn't it? Kofsky hopelessly exposed.
The man who has lost a Scottish Cup semi-final with Hibs and with Hearts has got the Jambos singing in Hampden. Chesnauskas. Here's Nielsen. Heading towards the half-hour mark. Skatzel. And Stuart Dougal. Not interested in the odd handball shout as Evan Sproul tries to burst away, but Bruno Aguiar sorts him out. Murphy. Smith. Benjulun. It's Whittaker again with another chance to strike, and he's had a few of those in this first half.
It's a good layoff in the chest from Benjulun. And Hearts took their time to get out and squeeze. It's Stephen Presley who eventually comes out to Whittaker. He's got time here, got a couple of touches. You'd have to say, of the two sides, very little cutting edge from Hibs. They really haven't managed to get their front players on the ball in the areas where they're going to hurt Hearts. Sproul in particular would want better service.
Hibs without their top scorer Derek Ryden, who's suspended, and as if that wasn't bad enough, they also lost Michael Stewart and Chris Killen and Scott Brown, all injured. It's a makeshift team, and Ryden having to watch from the stands. Murphy. Great, Gordon's come a long way, and Webster dealt with it, back by Fletcher, and Gordon grabs it.
That's a real misjudgment there from Craig Gordon. Goalkeeper comes that distance, he's got to get something on that. You certainly can't blame Webster for putting his head on it. He's not going to wait on a shoot in that area.
Yes, he doesn't do that very often, Craig Gordon. Outstanding keeper. Chesnaskis. Gary Smith stepped in. Nielsen kept it in. And Gonsalves. Hartley now seeking out Chesnaskis. Smith for Thompson. Murphy. Chesnaskis now for Nielsen. Ginkauskas.
President Andy Webster have been pretty clever the way they played this. They're well aware that Sproul would Thompson for pace in behind, and they haven't been in a hurry to squeeze again. They've sat reasonably deep, and although it has made the game longer for the midfield players in front of them, Hearts have the energy in that area of the pitch to play a long game.
Nielsen has slipped it through, and Markowski will beat Elliott to it.
The pass is just a little bit too straight. Not looking well from Callum Elliott.
Nielsen, who is Hart's longest serving player. Now Stuart Dougal wants a word with young Callum Elliott after that challenge.
Well, I think a younger referee might have been reaching for the yellow card here. I think Stuart Dougal can see that. Murphy got his feet up off the ground. Maybe not enough, a lot of malice in it, and a word is enough.
Smith's free kick, Benjaloon with the flick, just dropped the wrong side of Sproul. Gonsalves, whose family live in Switzerland, but the game isn't being shown there, so they've had to make a 9-hour trip to Lake Como in Italy to watch their boy in action. Chesnaskis. Hartley, Gonsalves, Aguiar, Whittaker shadowed by Gonsalves, who Arsenal fans might remember. He played for FC Tooten against them in the Champions League this season. Given against Gary Caldwell. More football to come today. The Football League Trophy from the Millennium Stadium. Carlisle against Swansea from 1:30 on Sky Sports 2. And from the Premiership at 4 on Sky Sports 1, it's West Ham against Charlton. Benjaloon. Tidy for Whittaker. There's a bit of room to manoeuvre for him. Just a little wide of Ivan Sproul. But he gets a corner off Andy Webster.
I think Webster's in control anyway. It's a good diagonal run there from Sproul. One of the few times they've got anything up the side. But Webster tracked the run all the way. This has looked their best bet so far. Thompson has hooked in a couple of good corners.
Here it comes from Kevin Thompson. Hartley and Whittaker on the edge of the area. Benjaloon now. And Stephen Glass with that strike.
Well, it's poor by his standards. He's got a very good left foot on him. And he's got plenty of time to set himself and measure this. And he's just smothered it completely. Just about sums Hibs up so far in this first half.
Well, Stephen Glass has lost two Scottish Cup semi-finals here with Aberdeen, two Hearts. And with Hearts to Dundee United last season. With Hibs rather. He also lost an English FA Cup semi with Watford. That time he got to the final, really, of something. Caldwell. Caldwell again. Here's the goal scorer, Hartley, for Gonsalves. Elliot jumping with Hogg. Glass now for Murphy. Aguiar, Portuguese midfielder. Chesnauskas. Elliot. Hartley. Looking to turn provider this time, but it would have to be better than that. We are.
Good tackle. That's bossing the game at the moment.
This is Jankauskas. Nielsen. Into the chest of David Murphy. Oh, it's Ivan Sproul who was lurking. Between them, Hartley and Presley deal with it. Fletcher. Some of Whittaker short, allowing Jankauskas to slide in. Hartley. Salves with a perfect pass for Skatzel. Jankauskas waiting. And Markowski would have to stick with him, and it did.
That's a very good save. Because Gary Smith's not goal side there. As it comes in, Jankauskas gets away from Gary Smith. Late run here, right across Gary Smith. That's good goalkeeping. Good ball in from Skatzel. Once again, Hearts make a good angle in the wide area. There's far more threat about Hearts.
If Hearts were to reach the final and finish second in the SPL, Gretna would be playing in Europe next season. I suppose they'll be pinching themselves by any chance. Bruno Aguiar. It's away by Chris Hogg. Getting the better of their Edinburgh rivals as we head towards half-time at Hampden. Murphy. Shaking off Chesnauskas as David Murphy. Now Whittaker, for the first time having a pop from range.
That's always rising. And I think he knows that Scatchell's closing him down here, that's why he takes it early. Nice little bit of space, Scatchell's getting across to him. Better build up from Hibs. And I don't think it's working up front for Hibs, and that's where it really matters today. In the absence of Chris Killen in particular, I think Sproul would have been much happier playing off a centre-forward type. As it is, he's been asked to play centre-forward. Benjulun is dropping off to get it into feet. And we're not really getting at Hearts.
Flag has stayed down here. It's Callum Elliott.
And Callum Elliott himself had a look across. He was surprised it stayed down. And there's not a lot in it. Assistants told to give the forward the benefit of the doubt. It's Chris Hawke who's deepest for Hibs.
Well, Valdis Ivanauskas was a striker in his day. Big burly striker by the look of it. Harry Smith getting a warning.
Dominant header previously by Stephen Presley. That's been the story of the match so far. Anytime it is knocked long, it's Webster and Presley who are winning everything.
Nielsen. Elliott. Hartley. Stuart Dougal had a think about that. Markowski coming a long way to palm it away to the corner.
Oh, I did enough. No harm done. As we said earlier, the goalkeeper comes out distance. He's got to get something on it, however little. He dealt with it.
A couple of minutes to go to half time, and Hibs fans will be fearing the worst. Second goal for Hearts now would be a major blow for the Hibs. Stuart Dougal having to keep watch on all the jostling. Kevin Thompson is the man who's getting a ticking off. Here it comes from Hartley, away by Gary Caldwell. Now, Ivan Sproul, and he's quick. He's got a bit to do yet. And Robbie Nielsen blocks the route to goal.
It's clever defending from Robbie Nielsen. Always determined to steer Ivan Sproul away from goal here. He stayed on his feet, determined not to dive and not to commit himself. Quite happy to concede a corner there.
Kevin Thompson's corner. Benjulun's header. Doing for Hibs, who are short in the striker department, hence Benjulun making his debut today. Chris Killen out injured, Derek Ryden suspended, Paul Dalglish cut side, and of course they sold Gary O'Connor to Lokomotiv Moscow. So it's all caught up with them a bit today, those striker problems. Here's Skatzel. Hart's looking for that second before the break, but Skatzel can't find a way across. Consalvis can't either. That might be a foul by Consalvis. And Whittaker.
I think previous to that there was a poor ball in from Skatzel. Jankowskis had just held his position, a better cutback, and Jankowskis is pulling the trigger. Look at Jankowskis here, just holds his position here, looking for a cutback. This isn't a difficult decision for Stuart Dougal.
Time coming to an end, but there might be some treatment required here. Presley. This is what happened to him.
Well, it's completely accidental. It's Benjelin, who's hardly off the ground when the contact's made. Stephen Presley's own determination to win it that gave him the problem.
Well, Stephen Presley had to go off at Falkirk last week, and there were fears that he might not make this semi-final. Doesn't look too clever there now. Right on the stroke of half-time. Concern for Valdis Ivanauskas. Him to stay down unless it's serious.
Well, Benjelin has to come right over the top here of Benjelin. He just caught the back of his head, but you mentioned he has had a few head knocks recently. I'll give him every chance to continue.
Valdis Ivanauskas exchanging a few words with the goal scorer. And there's only going to be a few seconds of the half left once Presley is okay. What have you made of the half, David?
Well, the better team is winning the match so far, that's for sure. You know, I did say earlier on there'll be a lot of tension, a lot of nerves, and there's no doubt the Hearts have settled the better of the two. They've played with far more expression, they've got more goal threat. They're making better angles in the wide areas. And Hibs have looked a pretty pale shadow of what we've seen from them earlier on this season. I don't think it's right up front. That much of that might be due to the fact that they're without Ryan and they're without Killen. And I think Tony's got a bit of thinking to do. Only 1-0 down, they're still in the match, but Hart's certainly bossing it right now.
Well, they'll check out Webster, and whilst they check him out, Gonsalves will cover his position. Fletcher, Hogg, and still the stoppage time continues. Was down for 2 or 3 minutes then, but I'm sure Stuart Dougal's whistle will go soon as Presley's return is greeted by the Hearts faithful. It is half time. Well, Paul Hartley spent 18 months at Hibs. It wasn't the best spell of his career, but he's having the time of his life now. His fourth goal in four games against them this season has given Hearts the edge in this Edinburgh Cup semi. Half-time at Hampden. Hibs 0, Hearts 1.
Yes, 1-0 to Hearts here at Hampden, as Ian Crocker rightly says. In a moment, the thoughts of Charlie Nicholas and Graham Ricks. But as things stand, Hearts on course for the final. Can Hibs get back into this? We shall see. We're back after this.
The Tennent Scottish Cup in association with Bet365.
Fabregas, goal! It's already 2-0 to Arsenal!
Now, can they finish the job in Turin? Juventus v Arsenal, Sky Sports 1.
Unreal! That is so finished! The magic is flowing! Oh!
And on Sky Sports 2, Barcelona Benfica.
Oh!
Huge night of Champions League action this Wednesday from
against Hearts, and it's 1-0 Hearts as things stand at the break. Graham Ricks and Charlie Nicholas are with me right now. Graham, what's your impression of that first 45 minutes?
I think both sides look a little bit nervous, especially the first 20 minutes or so. But I think Hearts look the more powerful, more controlled side, and I think they deserve to be winning.
Have Hibs disappointed you, Charlie?
Yeah. There's no fluency in the game, and because of that, it's creating this fear factor, if you like, the final ball in the good areas. Hearts have looked more composed at times than that, you know. Power running from midfield, bit of strength up front. I think they're waiting for something to happen, Hibs, rather than just going and doing it, taking a risk or two. And because of that, I think Hearts are more than deserved to be in front.
Big disappointment, Graham, for Hibs in the nature of the way the goal was scored for Hearts. I mean, giving it away as they did.
I was talking to Charlie beforehand, and you know, they want to play football, Hibs, and they're wide open when they do it. And, I mean, look at that. There's four against three there at one stage, look. And Hartley does what he does best. Forward runs into the box, great little touch.
Did you always encourage them to do that, Graham, when you
Absolutely.
Were there?
Absolutely. I mean, look how high up the pitch they are. They've won it, Scatchell. Then Hartley's still in their half. Yeah. And they're wide open, Hibs.
They are wide open. Now, originally, the pass comes into Benjamin, and when you're a striker, you have to link the play.
Got to.
But the midfield and even the full-backs have gone forward. And the problem is that Hartley's so advanced. Yeah. Rixey was telling me when the last derby game, he was the manager of when Hearts beat them four, that this is exactly what they do. Hibs' strength is to pass. I have to compliment the goal because it's a lovely pass and a determined run, a real desire from Hartley to get in there. But Gary Smith must come across as a defender. You've got to go where the danger is. But it was a good goal, and Hearts deserved it.
That little what-if mentality, Charlie, you know, as a defender, where you're playing it into midfield. What if it breaks down? What if he miscontrols it? And I think the Hibs lads want to play pure football and leave themselves open to that sort of counter-attack.
Graham, does Hearts marking at set pieces concern you?
Well, I just think once or twice the balls have come in and, you know, OK, corners, he's got away there. I think it's Webby, Andy Webster, gets away from. But I know they go zonal at wide free kicks, and I'm not a great lover of zonal defence. I think people can get a run on you, Charlie, you know, I mean, even for a little fella like yourself, if you've got a run on a big centre-half, you're going to get in.
It just takes one to switch off, doesn't it?
One mate, 1 second.
That's how much a fine line this is. I know Hearts are controlling a football match.
I think they are,
but
mate.
The longer this goes on at 1-0, 15 minutes, 20 minutes to go, the tension's there. Mm. One man switches off defensively, it could easily be an equaliser.
So what is Hibs' best chance then, Charlie, of getting back into this? They've got 45 minutes left.
I would bring on Killen personally quite quickly in the second half because I think they need somebody to take it in. Because if you start bombing by people, and this lad, Benjamin, he's new to the game. He doesn't really know his teammates yet. A flick, not controlling it, you're killed. The counter-attack, they get a second one, game's over.
Graham, if you still were the manager of Hearts and you know all these players very, very well, what would you be seeing in that dressing room at the moment?
Well, you know, we've been in many situations this season, Jim, where we've been leading at half-time, and the main theme of the half-time team talk is the next 20 minutes, the next goal has to be ours. And I think that's what they'll be saying in there at half-time. The next goal must be ours, because what do? Do you hang on for 1-0 or do you go out? And I just think the way they played that first half, they're going to get stronger and stronger.
Okay, well, Hearts in the driving seat, thanks to Paul Hartley. It is 1-0 to Heart of Midlothian. The second half is coming up after this.
2-0 is a dangerous score still, but if they can make it 2-0, they're in control of the game and I think they're going to go on and win it.
And of course it goes to a replay, remember, if it is level after 90 minutes, no extra time today. Charlie, can you see Hibs getting back into this and how?
Not at this moment in time. I mean, I mentioned Killen there, he's not made it. I thought maybe they could throw him on. Obviously he's not made it, so there's my big mistake of the afternoon. But I think looking at Hibs, you know, they've still got the pace of Sproul. They did try him on the left, so they've tried that. But Benjamin, he's not holding it in. Because of that, I think you've got to go beyond him. But that's a risk you've got to take. But I think Hibs have to force a risk or two now. But the full-back positions, I think Hearts will probably go in and maybe score an all and finish this.
All right, Charlie, Graham, for the moment, thanks. Let's see if either side are ringing the changes. Let's rejoin Davey and Ian.
Well, you can see that Paul Hartley, the goal scorer, has taken the captain's armband because Stephen Presley, who took that whack on the head, is unable to continue. So coming on in his place is Takis Fisas, who won the European Championships with Greece in 2004. He'll probably go to left back with Jose Gonsalves moving into the central defence where Gonsalves played last week against Falkirk. Stephen Presley has mild concussion after that knock, so Fisas is on. Hearts have lost their captain. Hibs though, well, they came into this game without several of their key players for various reasons, and frankly it's showed so far. They've had little to offer, They have 45 minutes to come up with something, or it'll be Hearts who'll be returning here on Saturday, May the 13th, for the 2006 Scottish Cup final. Gretna waiting.
Yeah, I think if you're Valdis Ivanauskas, you'll be saying at half-time, go and win the game now. The game's there to be won. Go and get the job done. There's been very little threat from Hibs in that first 45. I think it would be a mistake for Hearts to try and sit in this lead.
Here's Jankauskas, shadowed by Stephen Glass, and fouled by Stephen Glass.
That's in a good area as well. This gets a little bit too tight there, Stephen Glass, tackling with his right foot when it's a left foot challenge to be made. Scatzel has convinced Hartley it's a free kick that's more suited to him. Hearts load up the back post again.
Scatzel does indeed deliver. Webster nearly got his shot away. Wilson returning it to Craig Gordon. Ivan Stroud is quick, but that would have been asking too much even of him. Here's Murphy. Benjaloon, always watched by Gonsalves, now alongside Webster in the heart of the defence. Caldwell, who will be leaving Hibs in the summer to join Celtic. Another crude challenge by Hartley on Glass.
That's where you want to go and press the ball, or as high up the pitch as possible. You're giving away free kicks. Make sure it's not on the edge of your box.
Chris Hogg's free kick. Turned away by Andy Webster. Whittaker. Bruno Aguiar, free kick given against him. Alan Thompson.
And of the softer right it. Not a lot of contact, but to be fair to Stuart Dougal, there's only a few yards away. Probably get a better look at this than we have. Bit too far out for a strike, probably. Have to try and make an angle and get something into the box here.
Well, they've got Caldwell and Whittaker and Benjaloon to aim for. Thompson takes it. Fisas wins it. Thompson, stripped by Jankauskas.
This is the centre forward's challenge, it's mistimed.
Gary Caldwell, disappointing. Well,
that's poor. It's been poor all afternoon from that side of the pitch here. And you know, and Gary Caldwell, who you get credit for being one of the better defenders at distributing the ball, really has been poor from that side.
Jankauskas, Scatzel, Murphy holds him up temporarily. He's rather sandwiched then, Scatzel, and he's got a free kick. Glass and Thompson either side of him.
Well, again, Stuart Dougal's right in the middle of the action, and he tries to see if there's going to be an advantage, whether Hearts can retain possession. And eventually he's got a little choice but to bring it back, and this might be a nice range for Hartley.
Paul Hartley with the captain's armband now after Stephen Presley went off a concussion. It's Hartley, and might have taken a nick on route. Malkowski got across.
Well, the bigger target is on Malkowski's right-hand side. He goes towards his left-hand post. Certainly took a nick there off the top of the wall. Stephen Glass's shoulder, I think it came off. And it did Hibs a favour, it took the pace off it.
Hartley himself will take the corner, the man who scored in the first half, looking to turn provider. Not one of his better efforts though. No breakout for Benjaloon, but Hibs do get a throw. Since Hibs last won the Scottish Cup in 1902, yes, 1902, They've lost 8 finals. Callum Elliott getting a whack this time. Stephen Glass is falling on him at the bottom of the pile here. It was a leg that caused the damage. I don't think he'll be happy. I think even Ausis will feel that Hearts should put more daylight between the two sides here. And one thing you want to do, even if you lose a semi-final, you want to leave Hamden knowing you've given it your best shot. And I don't think Hibs can say that today. Not so far anyway, plenty of football left in the game, but we're going to have to change up a gear.
Webster.
Just the one goal in it, scored by Paul Hartley. Ivan Sproul. And Gonsalves, looks a decent player, fends him off.
It's the first time the Hibs have won that kind of first ball header that almost slips Sproul up the side of Gonsalves.
Kouskis for Fisas. And he sets up Rudy Skatzel. And Markowski smothers it.
And he's got to come back across the face of goal. Good ball.
Ivan Sproul, they fancy a bit of this. That's come off Gonsalves. That's going to be a corner.
Well, at least they're making Gonsalves turn there. That's what they didn't do in the first half. Just drop something in behind, get them turning, running towards their own goal. And Sproul certainly won't give that type of ball up.
The Hibs fans at that end, watching Kevin Thompson take the corner, and it was met by Robbie Nilsson. Thompson tries again with a decent angle, away by Webster. Paul Hartley chasing them all the way. And we are for Gonsalves. Stephen Glass, Benjaloo, Whittaker advancing forward. It's some ball back though for Kevin Thompson. And Skatchel trying to match his run.
Well, I'm just surprised he doesn't try and get across the front of Skatchel here. Get across the front of him into the box and Skatchel can't make a challenge. If not, try and square it into the area. Support arriving at the back post. They may have sat up just a little bit as he tried to play it. What a good ball from Benjulin to get him in there.
Well, Hibs have scored goals galore in the Scottish Cup this season. 6 against Arbroath, 3 at Rangers, 5 at Falkirk. I'll be hoping they haven't used up all their goals yet in this competition. It's offside. Lithuanian now in charge of Hearts, Valdas Ivanauskas, who also worked for Vladimir Romanov at Kaunas. Life is certainly never dull at Hearts. Season that began with George Burley in charge and began with their best ever league start since 1914. Then Burley departed, Graham Ritz took over and continued in a similar vein. And then it was bye-bye to him. Presumably Vanaskis will be in charge if Hearts do get to the final. In fact, he won the Lithuanian Cup last season. And he'll follow that up with a Scottish Cup. Elliott and Kaskis. Is Maskus chasing, giving Gary Smith a problem. Robbie Nielsen will try a long throw. Good distance on that, but Gary Smith met it. Chesnauskas up against Fletcher, taking him on and taking on Murphy too. Caldwell with time to clear. Hartley making up so much ground as usual. Sproul, not quite. It's been a not quite kind of day for Hibs. Hartley, Callum Elliott. Chris Hogg is going to come across. Oh, it looked like he took out Elliott then, and he's going to get the first yellow card of this All Edinburgh Cup semi-final.
Well, I was saying he took the ball as he followed through, though. That's why Stuart Dougal is reaching for his card. Stuart Dougal, just try to let as many of them go as possible, but there comes a time.
Yes, I don't normally wait 56 minutes for a yellow card in the derby. Free kick, promising position. Hartley takes it. It's going to come to Chesnauskas, who elects not to hit it straight away. And now he's lost it. Sproul is charging away. Everyone else struggling to keep up with him.
Well, very similar to the situation at the Hearts goal in the first half, where this time it was Chesnauskas who lost it deep inside the Hibs half. Almost punished.
Bisas. Foul. Great kick. Good position again. Very similar to the last one.
Well, I had an offer from Skatzel, who was trying to get in behind. Clearly taken there. Always awkward, these ones to defend. Nightmare for a goalkeeper, because Hartley will whip this in right on top of him.
Webster and Gonsalves have come up predictably. Hartley goes for goal, and he's found it. A stunning strike. Paul Hartley does it again. Now they are dreaming of a place in the final.
Well, if Mokoski decides that he doesn't want a two-man wall there, it's got to be more central. And he's just been totally outwitted by wonderful technique from Paul Hartley. And the one in the wall, Kevin Thompson, got to say, I think the goalkeeper, I don't think the goalkeeper should be beaten from that angle. Taking nothing away from Hartley, who gets great action on the ball. But I'll tell you what, Tony Mowbray will not be happy with his keeper being beaten from there.
He knew it was going in, didn't he? Paul Hartley has taken the captain's armband and has provided a captain's contribution to the Hearts' cause. And there is such a long way back for Hibs now. The Jambos are on their feet. Half of Hampden is singing and dancing. The other half fearing the worst now, but Hearts have been by far the stronger team. And Hibs' list of absentees proving to be rather costly. Hibs beaten in the semi-finals here last year by Dundee United. Could be a similar story, but hang on, because here's Whittaker. Away by Chesnauskas. Gary Caldwell. That's the free kick. And Callum Elliott getting in the way. And he's going to get a yellow card for that.
Otherwise, Whittaker is on his way. Gary Cole will try to take a quick one. And Elliot doing what a lot of players would have done. He's going to pay the price now.
Elliot joins Hogg in the book. Hibs need a response. And they need it here. Here and now. Thompson floating it in. And it could still happen for them. Sproul turning it back.
First chance in the match, the Hearts have really looked exposed in the wide areas. And again, I think Sproul's trying to pick the right option there. He's not going to score from that angle.
Here is Whittaker. Great strike beaten away by Gordon. A reasonable height for the keeper. Murphy, Stephen Glass will advance. Webster won it. And Nielsen stays cool.
Cole just in a hurry here to take the free kick because Stephen Whittaker is ahead of him here unmarked. And Elliot, well, it's understandable, but it's an automatic yellow.
Well, Hibs are going to bring on the giant striker, Amadou Conte, shortly. He hails from Mali. And Tony Mowbray will be hoping he's the answers to a few Hibi prayers. Stephen Glass is the man going off. And on comes Conte. Who
substitution for
was Cambridge United last
Glass
year.
The field, the oncoming player 19, Amadou Conte.
He's a big lad. Hibs need somebody to stand up and be counted now. Hearts are in command of this semi-final. And they'll be rather pleased watching in and around Gretna, no doubt, because if Hearts hang on to second spot and reach the cup final, European football would beckon for Gretna.
It'll just be interesting to see how that affects the Hibs shape. It looks as if Sproul's going to drop off, play a little bit deeper, which surprises me. Conte up front now with Benjamin.
Webster still won it despite Conte's presence. Here's Gary Smith. Now Sproul. He's done well. Still a bit crowded out though. And Hibs will accept the corner. Hibs fans hoping that something will come to the corner, but it's long for Kevin Thompson. And it's Scatson who's going to bring it away. Elliot. Hartley. Hibs are a bit short. Hartley has to sidestep Smith. Chesnauskis or Jankauskis, the two Lithuanians. Caldwell not doing Stephen Whittaker many favours there.
Well, that second goal is taking so much of the stress out of this match for Hearts. It's going to weather the next 5-10 minutes. Big spell in the game. If Hibs are to get back into it, they need one now.
Here's Callum Elliott. Get past Gary Smith, no he can't. Stephen Whittaker, Scottish under 21 international. Conte just on. Thompson now for Murphy. Gary Caldwell and towards Conte. Benjaloon went for the overhead kick, but snuffed out by Gonsalves.
It's good defending. It's a badge in the back, but it's good defending. Made sure he wasn't going to get a clean overhead kick at it.
Scatzel. Smith. Conte. Fisas hurt. Touching his knee.
I think it's accidental. It was Conte, but it was accidental. Well, it looks as if he's struggling. Well, it looks as if it's a knot. Hopefully it's a knot, not a twist. It's the left foot that comes up onto the left knee of Fisas. Should be okay.
Well, they kicked the ball out because he was injured there, Fisas, but Hibs deciding their need is urgent. Caldwell. Craig Gordon will claim it. There's a foul anyway by Conte, who gave Gonsalves the shove, and he's now down. That's the field though, so they'll be able to carry on.
Well, the ball forward from Gary Caldwell gave Conte no chance at all. Gonsalves was just waiting for Craig Gordon coming to take it.
Craig Gordon could be in bother with Stuart Dougal here, because Gonsalves is off the field, and Dougal wants Gordon to get on with it, but just pointing out that it's a head wound, I think. Doesn't matter though, he's going to get a yellow card for time wasting. Well, it's great really for Stuart Dougal, because
he's just making up for lost time.
Well, it looks quite bad for Gonzalez.
If it's a head injury, then Craig Gordon's got a point.
Yeah, it does look bad actually. Well, they've already lost Stephen Presley with a mild concussion. And now Gonsalves is down. And not looking too promising for him to continue. Whittaker. Conte chasing this. Ooh, nearly got there.
Good goalkeeping again though. Craig Gordon out very quickly. Just sweeping it. At times his hearts do push up a bit.
Well, Gonsalves still off the field getting treatment. And they might have to rejig that defence again. Fisas has gone in alongside Webster for the time being. And they are going to bring on Mikalunas Hart.
It was Caldwell with the ball forward. Conte has no chance of getting it. And it was a collision with Craig Gordon himself. Craig Gordon's shoulder that did the damage.
So Gonsalves has to be replaced, and Andy Webster will have yet another partner in the heart of the defence in Fisas, because coming on
substitution,
another Lithuanian,
number 16,
Saulius Mikalunas,
coming on for 34, Jose Gonsalves.
And Hibs are making a change as well, and Umar Conde is going to come on for them. Swiss defender who joined in January from Hansa Rostock. He was actually at Blackburn for a while when Brian Kidd was in charge. He's taken the place of Benjeloud, the Moroccan, making his debut today. It was always going to be a big ask of him to perform in a semi-final on his debut.
I've got Chisnowskis and Mikalunas in the wide areas now, but it's Fisas, as you said, in beside Andy Webster. Scatzel now playing left back.
Hartley takes.
Not a great deal of height in that Hearts back line now. You'd imagine that Hibs will be a lot more direct in what remains of this game, especially with Conte up through the middle now.
Mikalunas just on. Hearts throw. Gonsalves still being attended to. And there's real concern around him there. After he collided with his own keeper. Wilson's long throw. Twenty minutes left of this Edinburgh Cup showdown. Mikalunas gets a free kick.
Well, the assistant has certainly forgiven it. Stuart Dougal has agreed. Linesman couldn't have been any closer to it. Well, that's clear enough. And Sutton, well, just about Paul Hart's out of sight here.
Paul Hartley has scored both goals for Hearts. Will it be Hartley the provider this time? Turned away by Smith. It's going to come to Bruno Aguiar. Oh, he's put Hartley in again. Blocked by Murphy. Mikalunas, and onto the roof of the net. It was a concern for Markowski.
Yeah, I think Mikalunas will feel he should be doing better here. You know, he's got in behind here. He's got a bit of time to get something across the face of goal. He's sat up a little bit as he tries to knock it in. Should be doing better though.
Sproul. Fletcher takes over. Just no way through for Hibs yet, but if they could sneak one, it would change the picture considerably. And they're going to get a free kick as Murphy is taken out. It's going to be a yellow card being shown here. Bruno Aguiar has got it. Hibs hoping this is their moment. Thompson takes it. It's not their moment though. The seconds tick agonisingly away. Just to confirm that booking there for Aguiar, but they still haven't taken Gonsalves away yet. There's been a lot of looks at him from the medics there. Well, they got him on a stretcher. Another free kick for Hibs, but they need to make one count. Kevin Thompson takes. Gordon got something on it, and Stephen Whittaker has hoisted it far too high.
Well, again, Craig Gordon was willing to come and try and take the pressure off Andy Webster and Fisas. Good ball into a dangerous area. Didn't manage to get it wide, Gordon. But Mikalunas was pressing there as Whittaker trying to get the ball on target. Still no real sign that Hibs are getting themselves back into this game.
Well, Hearts, that's a handball from Conte, but Hearts losing Stephen Presley and Jose Gonsalves to head injuries, and of course they go to Celtic on Wednesday night. Gordon Strachan's side could clinch up the title. It does look bad though for Gonsalves. Bruno We're at Hampden Park, down at the Millennium Stadium now on Sky Sports 2. You can see Carlisle against Swansea in the Football League Trophy Final. And later you can see West Ham against Charlton in the Premiership. Sky Sports 1 at 4. Aguiar. Hartley first to that. He's first to quite a lot. It's 5 goals against Hibs this season. Callum Elliott. Tracked by Conde. Thompson. Advantage played amid the grappling between Mikalunas and Thompson, but now the free kick is given. Stuart Dougal tried to play the advantage. Rudy Scatzel. Went off the boil a bit, Scatzel, after an impressive season. He is Hearts' top scorer still. 17 on loan at the moment, and there are rumours that George Burley might like to buy him again. Southampton. Scatzel's cross dealt with by Murphy, and here's Sproul.
Great defender, Mikalunas, wonderful defender,
and he get a free kick as well. Oh, now surely there's big bother here. It is. Evan Sproul sees red and Hibs, there he goes from bad to worse.
That challenge, and that running that challenge just about sums up Hart's determination. They've got far more conviction about him this afternoon. Sproul thinks he's on his way. Mikalunas is not giving it up. Good tackle. Then can't get the ball out of his feet. And as he goes down, well, no excuse for that.
Well, that's ridiculous from Sproul, and any chance Hibs had of a recovery, and it hasn't looked too likely in truth, surely gone now, and it looks like they will have to take a really sore one here, losing to their Edinburgh rivals in a Scottish Cup semi-final, and some of them have seen enough already. Ridiculous stamp from Sproul. Hartley. Well, the Scottish Cup have been good to Ivan Sproul up until then. He had scored in every round, but that run has come to an end. Hibs are down to 10 men. And all the injuries they had, and of course, suspensions too, have caught up with them. But they might have a few regrets anyway about the way they performed, despite those telling absentees. Is there life in Hibs yet? Thompson centre. Smith. Chesnaskis will leave it for Fisas. Elliott. Caldwell. Thompson, hope yet, but Webster turns it away.
Good defending. Defended that front post so well today, Hearts. On a rare occasion, Hibs have got in behind the full-backs. Two centre-backs really have squeezed well in the front post area. And let's get it in the box time for Hibs now. Two big fellas up front. Forget the slow build-up game. Go long.
Conte, well, he's still going. And it's Hartley who has to dig it out. 10 minutes for Hibs to save themselves, but it's going to take a monumental effort, and that there is no doubt. Oh, and Markowski with another error, and Jankowskis wraps it up. It doesn't get much better than this, beating your fierce rivals in a Scottish Cup semi. Bring on Gretna.
I think Ziggy Markowski's got to hold his hands up again. He was always favourite to win it. He didn't seem to check here.
Goal scorer from Hearts.
Seemed to check, let Jankowskis in. No way back after that. And he was always favourite to win this, the Hibs goalkeeper. Then checked. Thought he had more time than he had. And to be fair to Jankowskis, who wasn't prepared to give it up, he gets his reward. And that really is lights out now for Hibs.
Well, second and third goals won't be viewed much on Markowski's video machine, I think. Jankowskis, who won the Champions League with Porto, although he was left on the bench by Jose Mourinho for the final, is now after the Scottish Cup, and there's going to be a change from either side here. Hibs are going to bring on Jamie Markowski, and Hearts are going to bring on Michael Pospisil, the Czech striker who scored a cracker against Aberdeen in this cup run. Callum Elliott off and Pospisil on, and Stephen Fletcher's coming off for Hibs.
Substitution for Hibs.
Comes Jamie McCluskey, 18 years of age. He's going to get his first taste of the Edinburgh Derby experience, but it's going to be a rather sour taste for all those involved with Hibs. And their half of Hampden is emptying quickly now. Whittaker, and steps Mikalunas. Skatzel. Caldwell. Murphy. Well, as the rows continued over Sproul's stamp and red card, Paul Hartley and Kevin Thompson both picked up yellow cards. Now, that would have ruled Kevin Thompson out of the final, but of course, that won't matter now. He's not going there. Heart of Midlothian are. Valdis Ivanauskas, who's only just replaced Graham Ricks, is going to take Hearts through to the final. Although it was Graham Ricks who took them this far to the semi-final. It's been a bit of a roller coaster ride at Hearts this season, and the ride has rarely stopped. Conte. And he's got a free kick.
He did well to win one. Well outnumbered there. Didn't appear to have anywhere to go. Anything Hibs get now won't be anything more than a consolation.
Well, Kevin Thompson might go for it, might as well. Thompson does go for it. Craig Gordon saw it coming all the way.
Carried full toss into his arms as well. If it bounces in front of him, it might have given him a little bit of a problem. But an easy enough catch for the Scotland keeper.
Well, Hibs' long wait to win the Scottish Cup goes on and on and on and on. 1902, the last time they lifted the famous trophy. They just cannot get rid of that particular millstone. Hearts have only won it twice in the last 99 years themselves. 1998, the last time. Here's Whittaker. Mikalunis now charging away. Pospisil in the middle, but Markowski will collect.
Took a bobble. He seems about to cross in. Suffers not the best today after 90 minutes on it yesterday.
Well, Hart's remarkable season is going to end with the Scottish Cup final date, Saturday, May the 13th, against Gretna here at the National Stadium. It's only an hour between Glasgow and Edinburgh, but I bet that journey back for the Hibs fans will feel a bit longer. Losing a semi-final is bad enough, but losing to your city rivals really did not bear thinking about. Now they have to think about it. Rest assured, they won't be allowed to forget it. Pospisil chasing this. Oh, he's been held back. And Gary Smith's going to get a red card, surely.
There's no choice.
Gary Smith is sent off. Hibs are down to 9 men. And it's a pen.
I hate to say it again, but I think Markowski should come for this. The ball from Paul Hart has travelled 50, 60 yards. Expected to see the goalkeeper coming out, stayed where he was. And that is not a difficult decision for Stuart Dugan. You can see his angle here, it's perfectly placed to see it.
Paul Hartley is going to be on a hat-trick. Harry Smith sent off, Ivan Sproul sent off. Paul Hartley has never ever scored a hat-trick. This would be the time. Here comes Hartley, and here comes a hat-trick. What a hero, a superhero. 3 for Hartley, 4 for Hearts, and Jambo's dreams have come so very true.
Double deserved hat-trick for Paul Hartley as well. A penalty, a free kick, and a wonderful first goal that broke the deadlock. It sums up the confidence of a player who's right at the top of his game and who developed very late in his career. But a top-drawn midfield player these days.
Paul Hartley, hat-trick hero, and what a player he has been over the last couple of years. Absolutely outstanding. The ironic thing is, he was at Hibs, of course, never quite happened for him then. It's all happening for him now. Hat-trick in the Scottish Cup semi since Billy Dodds got one here for Rangers a few years ago. Wonder who your man of the match might be, Davey.
Well, it's a no contest, isn't it? Paul Hartley, head and shoulders, complete performance. Got the vital goal that broke the deadlock, settled the nerves. A terrific free kick, even though I think Markowski was at fault for Hart's second, and he's just rounded off there a moment ago. Wonderful 90 minutes from the Scotland midfielder. He's my tennis man of the match.
Well, he's now scored 6 times against his former club Hibs this season, and 3 of them have come from the penalty spot. But certainly Markowski in the Hibs goal has hardly covered himself in glory, and Hibs seeing this game out now with 9 men after red cards for Sproul for stupidly stamping and for Gary Smith who pulled Pospisil back. Could it really be any worse for Hibs? Well, only if Hearts continue to score. There's going to be just 2 minutes added on though, and Hibs will probably be rather grateful. You won't see many cheerful faces around the Leith area of Edinburgh today. Tony Mowbray's side have been well beaten here, but in the Gorgie area of the Scottish capital, I think they'll be having quite a night somehow. Hearts are heading through to the 2006 Scottish Cup final, where they will meet Gretna, and what an intriguing final that will be. Well, Ivanauskas has done the last bit on this cup run. Paul Hartley's hat-trick for Hearts has ensured that their Edinburgh rivals, Hibs, have been well beaten. And Vladimir Romanov, who's had his critics, plenty of them, will be coming back here next month. Two men who've put their money into the clubs, Brooks Marlson at Gretna and Vladimir Romanov here at Hearts. They'll be contesting the Scottish Cup final. It's the third time this season that Hearts have scored four goals against Hibs. They did so twice at Tynecastle. A different manager for most of the derbies each time. Hibs looking for a consolation, but there can be no consolation for them. Hearts are in the final. They will return here next month. Valdis Ivanauskas, the man in charge now, but Graham Rich can take a fair bit of credit too, and George Burley for starting it all off. It's been the strangest of seasons with Vladimir Romanov in charge, but it's a season that will end with a Scottish Cup final appearance for Hearts against Gretna. Paul Hartley, the hat-trick hero, and a quite simply breathtaking individual performance. Two teams who certainly have their fair share of stories to tell this season will meet in the final. It's agony for Hibs, it is ecstasy for Hearts, and when you thrash your city rivals like this, you can't beat it. And just to add another touch, it means they're in the final.
Well, you know, semi-finals here are usually pretty ugly, always very tense, but as soon as Hearts got in the driving seat through the first goal, they really did boss the game from there on in, and they simply blew Hibs away this afternoon. They certainly will be odds-on favourites to win the Scottish Cup final against Gretna.
Can't blame them for milking the moment. It's been some story this season for Hearts, and the story continues. Good to see Stephen Presley getting involved there, but no doubt about the man of the moment, Paul Hartley. Scored the first two goals, Jankowski's in between, got a third, and then Hartley from the penalty spot. Glasgow belongs to Hearts. Edinburgh belongs to Hearts. The 2006 Scottish Cup final will be between Hearts and Gretna.
So Hearts fans happy here at Hampden this afternoon. Plenty more live action coming your way, Sky Sports 2. Right now, the Football League Trophy final. You can catch Carlisle against Swansea. And then at 4 o'clock on Sky Sports 1, it's a Premiership, it's West Ham against Charlton. Well, big disappointment for Hibs today. The all-Edinburgh affair, and really only one side in it, and that was Hearts. And as Ian Crocker said, they will now play Gretna in the final. Still sounds strange, doesn't it? In the final of the Tennent Scottish Cup. The thoughts of Charlie and Graham in just a moment. But Hearts have done it, and in some style. And that man has had a field day. Paul Hartley, man of the match. He's won it for them. We're back after this.
The Tennent's
Hearts beat their Edinburgh rivals Hibs here at Hampden this afternoon, and in some style, and that man ran the show. Paul Hartley, ultimately man of the match, set them on their way, and what about that for his second goal? And it got worse and worse this afternoon for Hibs as time went on. Ivan Sproul, the red mist descended, and he stamped on Mikalunas. So, there were two down and a man down. And then this, a dreadful mess at the end. Jankauskas made it 3-0. And it wasn't over yet. Then this happened, Gary Smith. He committed the offence. And then there were nine. Paul Hartley took it and slotted it, his first ever hat-trick. Not surprisingly, Paul Hartley was man of the match here at Hampden Park this afternoon, and he's with David Tanner.
Paul, congratulations. A victory dance at Hampden Park. Does it get much better than that?
No, it doesn't. First final for a lot of the players, and especially beat your rivals is fantastic. And to play the way we did today was exceptional, and really pleased for the fans who have came in great numbers this season.
Is this the pinnacle of your club career?
Probably, yeah. Doesn't get much better scoring a hat-trick in a semi-final at Hampden, and you know, I'm delighted to be there in May the 13s, and we've still got a lot to play for.
How would you describe the team performance today, Paul?
Absolutely fantastic. Right through to everybody. We had to make a couple of substitutions with Stephen Ganoff and Hosey, but the boys that came in done brilliant. We were right up for the game. I could just sense it all week that we were going to win today.
Psychologically, how difficult has it been for the players, given all the controversy, the change of the manager 11 days ago and all that's gone with that?
It's not been difficult at all, because we've won 4-0, so it just shows you that the character we've got in the squad.
Playing like that, is your name on the cup?
Hopefully, but we'll have a tough game against Gretna. They played very well yesterday, so we're just delighted to be there.
Paul, for scoring 3 goals against Hibs, 6 for the season against Hibs, you're the tenants man of the match. Well done.
Thank you, that's my boys. Brilliant. Yes!
Paul Hartley, very, very happy indeed. Tell me about this fella. You know this lad well. What's he like in training?
Super. He's enthusiastic. Great trainer. Sets a great example. And, you know, I think he's capable of going on to bigger and better things. There's no doubt about that.
Could he do it in the Premiership, do you think?
Well, I think you saw today. His energy levels are unbelievable. He's a tidy footballer. He gets in the box. And, I mean, the goals he scored. Great goals. Delighted for him.
Charlie, 4-0 sounds a thrashing, but it was a thrashing, wasn't it?
It was a justified 4-0. I think at half-time we were, you know, I felt as if Hearts could have been 2 or 3 up in the first half, to be honest. They bossed the game, didn't get a threat. I mean, and Graham was sitting thinking to himself, Hearts have not had an opportunity, and one attempting goal in the first half, an easy save for Gordon. I was surprised that when Celtic had the opportunity to take Hartley, they didn't go and take him. I think he's 29 now.
29, yeah.
He's been about, he's done his shift, but he's groomed into a smashing player. I would be surprised. I'm surprised with some of the candidates for Player of the Year this year, but I think Hartley definitely is right in the frame.
You know, Graham, I know Tony Mowbray, and I like him, but I felt like his demeanour at the top of the programme set the tone. You know, they're beleaguered, they've got key men out, but you still have to say, but no matter what, we're going to give this a real go today, and that didn't come over to me.
Well, I like Tony. I know Tony Mowbray's a smashing lad, but I just thought before the game when we spoke about it, it just seemed a little bit negative. It was, oh, we're missing this player, we're missing that player, and I think that showed in Hibs' performance. I don't think they had any real belief that it could go out and score the goal, win the game. So I'm a little disappointed today in Hibs.
Let's hear from him now, Graham. Tony Mowbray is with David.
Tony, can you sum up the size of the disappointment tonight?
Oh, well, I think there'll be a lot of people driving down the M8 back east, very, very disappointed. We had an opportunity today. You know, things didn't transpire as well as we'd have liked regarding the availability of some of our better players. But ultimately the team we put out there, I thought, competed very well for long periods of the game. I don't think there was much in it for staff at all. From their point of view, it was a good goal. I suppose we got caught on the counter really a little bit, them breaking from midfield. But second half, you know, 3 goals really, all very, very poor goals. You know, I wouldn't normally talk about good goals or bad goals, because ultimately semi-finals about getting through, but I think when you break down and analyse the football match, the 3 goals we lost second half were extremely poor from our perspective.
Was Paul Hartley in many ways the difference between the sides today?
No, I don't think so. I think Paul, for his first goal, was typical Hartley. I think breaking in, they broke very quickly, and he's got great energy levels to get in the 6-yard box, and you see him doing that week in, week out. You can't take away from the quality of the free kick. Obviously we're disappointed with the with the nature of the second goal, but great quality from him. But I don't think he was. I don't think he was ubiquitous right around the pitch all game. He was Paul Hartley. What he does, he runs forward. He doesn't get involved a lot. He ends up in the 6-yard box and gets a lot of goals.
Two players sent off. Did the referee have any choice?
Oh, I don't know. Did he? You ask him. I'm not sure. We're disappointed, obviously, to finish with 9 men in such a big game. But bottom line is we didn't probably have enough out there today to win the game. Good luck to Hearts. We'll see where they go. We've got I think we've got 7 league games now to finish as high as we can in this league, and see if we can put some pressure on the teams above us to try and qualify for a European spot.
Tony, Hardlines.
Cheers, David. Thanks. All right, mate.
So, confirmation then. That is how the Scottish Cup final will shape up. It will be between Little Gretna, who have got their, really on merit, magnificent effort, up against Hearts. Hamden, of course, will be there for that. Charlie, I got the impression it was never going to be Hibs' day.
No, well, they didn't have the quality available, and Riordan's a big miss for them. The boy Killen, who I don't know, for some reason I always thought was on the bench. I knew he was struggling all week. Brown, who wasn't match fit, so he stuck him on the bench. But I know it's easy for me sitting in a studio, and Mogger, I know him as a person, he ain't the most outgoing in terms of, showing a strong emotion. But I think a lot of the young players can come in here with attention and naivety, if you like, about playing. For 6 months of the season, I thought they were the best passing team in the country, Hibs. But they run out of legs and they run out of variation, and suddenly they don't have a plan B. And I think the cleverness and the experience of people at Hearts can pick them off.
Graham, let me ask you, how did you feel in the studio this afternoon? Because this is the first time you've seen Hearts. You were very, very emotionally wound up about what happened when you left. Did you kick every ball this afternoon? Did you feel wound up for them?
I was slightly relaxed watching the game because I fancied Hearts to win before the match, and I'm absolutely delighted for the guys because they've had so much to contend with throughout this season, Jim, and I'm just delighted that they're through to the cup final.
Will you take the opportunity to pop down and see them today?
I might do.
You were invited.
Yeah, I'm sure I'll be made very welcome by the lads. But, it is their day, so I'll probably let them get on with it.
Would you shake the current coach's hand?
Of course I would. I did before the game, yeah.
Great stuff, Graham. I feel sorry for Hibs in many ways, but now we know that the final, Charlie, will be between Gretna and Hearts. And Gretna, it really is a fairy tale story. They came here yesterday. It was a big, big challenge. They probably couldn't believe they were in the semi-final of the Scottish Cup. And really, again, late this afternoon, there was only one team in it.
Well, I think they got a half time, second half, before they really started to believe in themselves. But Duker, who's had another fantastic goal-scoring season, the doctor, as Jeff Stirling likes to call him, it's a sharp and a well-controlled finish, isn't it? Because it's an awkward angle.
Yeah. He did well there, Graham, didn't he?
He did.
And then the second goal, well, Gretna, they deserve this, Charlie, because they did push forward. They didn't just hang around at 1-0.
The thing about Gretna that a lot of people won't know about, it's Little Gretna. But they were taking guys out of the SPL from Dundee United and teams like that and paying them decent money. James Grady. These guys can score goals. McGuffey gets the penalty. But when you're starting to get that in your dressing room, and you're starting to get into games, all right.
Good experienced pros, they know what they're doing.
Graham, how will Hearts feel about Gretna?
I tell you, I think it's a difficult game for Hearts because I think they came here today, Hearts, against their local rivals. No one was quite sure which way it was going to go, but I think they're going to expect to beat Gretna. And we've seen already, Gretna are a good footballing side, and as Charlie was saying, a lot of experienced players. And it's not going to be easy. It's not always easy playing with pressure on you. No.
Just in case you're wondering, just in the passing, you saw Gonsalves, the Hearts player, this afternoon. He picked up a real bad injury. Now, what? We don't know. He was unconscious for fully 2 minutes, and we haven't had an update yet. We hope he's going to be pulling through. Charlie, Gretna Hearts. Can Gretna win it?
Yeah, they can win it. I don't think they will. I think Hearts, although I agree with Rixie, it's tense, it's hard, because they'll just sit in and they'll make it awkward for you. Have you got big enough players? Well, we've seen today they've got big enough players.
More live football coming your way on Sky Sports. Sky Sports 2 right now. It's Carlisle Swansea, the Football League Trophy Final. And then later on today on Sky Sports 1, it's a 4 o'clock kickoff. It's West Ham against Charlton. And at 8 o'clock tonight, Sky Sports 1, it's the Seville Derby. It's Real Betis against Sevilla. Well, this afternoon, for the first time ever, Hearts played Hibs outside Edinburgh, and Hearts won it 4-0. And they will play Gretna in the final. My thanks to Charlie Nicholas, and in particular to Graham Ricks. Yeah, great to see you.
Enjoyed it, mate.
From me, bye for now.
Sports coverage of the Tennent Scottish Cup in association with Bet365.